This my intro in which I rap like a SoundCloud hero. The pace is fast, that's how long you last when you stick it in your girlfriend's oversized ass. This my vid. Let's start off with some face cam footage. I should probably certainly show my face, mom. I'm scared that I might bumble that flow.
Hello, my fellow happy citizens of the world.
Whoopsies, I mean tiny insignificant cogs in a machine run by meddling SCPs with an unyielding urge to privatize the concept of dopamine neurotransmission.
In all seriousness, however, is reality run by SCPs? Is our world under the influence of a group of anomalous entities that were written in by an internet dweller from a higher plane of existence?
Hold on, I need to organize myself before I do something as freaking crazy as... What are these images? Why?
Pretentious existentialism aside, there's a certain random dude I want to talk about for a hot number of minutes. His name is Dr. Jack Bright, and he looks like this. And this. And this. Also that. Not to mention, long story, we'll get back to that in a bit. Generally speaking, he's one of the top dogs of the SCP Foundation and low-key responsible for documenting several anomalies, like a pinwheel that makes people go,
"You dare block the way of the almighty Mr. Smith, random wall built in the middle of nowhere? I'll have you know that I am literally the almighty second coming of Jesus Christ, and I will strike you down with my almighty pinwheel of doom! Almighty pinwheel beam of destruction! Ha! Take that, random wall built in the middle of nowhere! I shall now continue my journey toward almighty dominance! I have a strange feeling that I shouldn't have been able to do that. Off to kill myself."
Out of all the adjectives supported by adverbs you could use to describe Dr. Bright, I'd say the most accurate one of them all would be, utterly unhinged.
And I'm sure we'd make wonderful friends.
Right now, you're looking at a list of 287 things that a single person, Dr. Bright, is not allowed to do.
He has become such a nuisance to the organization that one could confidently claim that more time has been spent laying out this list of restrictions
than the amount of time it has taken to record all of the SCPs on the forum.
Okay, maybe not all the SCPs, but it's still hilarious as shit.
Dr. Bright is not allowed to feed anything with peanut butter to Kane. Nuts. Telling new researchers that you could tame SCP-682 with a rolled up newspaper and a tummy rub is right out. What level of nihilism is this dude on? If it involves doing something wrong, it isn't right. If it involves doing something right, you did it wrong.
The enthusiasm is hype.
Dr. Bright may not put a cup of orgasm from SCP-294 through SCP-914 on the very fine setting. Dr. Bright may not use SCP-294 to create a cup of mimetic orgasm and use it on worldwide television. Dr. Bright is not permitted to use SCP-294 to create orgasms of any kind, mimetic, sentient, or otherwise. Dr. Bright is not allowed to show SCP-682 any of the following. Any Bull movies, The Room, Troll 2, Manos, The Hands of Fate. I get it, it's like Dr. Bright is trying to get along with the hard-to-destroy reptile by showing it the worst movies made by human beings, because it hates humanity and all other forms of life. That is so clever. We really should change Dr. Bright's name from Dr. Bright to Dr. Clever. Hold on, isn't his name...
Oh my gosh, I'm stupid!
The ultimate showdown of Ultimate Destiny is not grounds to pit more than 15 combative SCPs, including SCP-682 and Abel, against each other. Alright, so Dr. Bright's getting it wrong. What you really gotta do is rent the Madison Square Garden, set up a modified elimination chamber so that there are 14 cells instead of 4, blackmail SCP-079 into booking the match, and promise the participants freedom for cooperating. You may feel like the scum of the earth for not being a man of your word, but that's what amnestics are for, right?
Also the money!
Dr. Bright is not to use this list as a resume.
"Hey guys, my name is Dr. Jack Bright and I'm so edgy."
That's Dr. Bright.
Look, I could read and commentate on all 287 entries of the list and it would still make for a great video despite the horrifically long-lasting length, but the thing is, I don't like being unoriginal, and there's a lot more to Dr. Bright than just being a comic relief utensil in a multiverse that somehow hasn't annihilated itself yet.
Let's move on to unwarrantedly making fun of his appearance like a real comedian.
I mean, just look at his hair. I bet no woman wants to have the S-word with him simply because of the color of his hair, burdened by outdated and unfunny stereotypes that depict people like him as losers without a soul. Unlike my hair, which is very dark brown and superior to the color of his hair because it's popular and awesome.
Wait, hold on, why the hell did Dr. Bright suddenly become the supreme deity among men? That's not fair at all. I'm supposed to be objectively better than him. Let's talk about SCP-963-1, an amulet that seems to be absolutely indestructible for some reason. It's got an outer ring of shiny white gold, 13 brilliant cut diamonds, a big old ruby in the middle, and it'll make all you aspiring trad wives out there piss and shit and come when you see it. Now, at some point in the past, there was a containment breach of SCP-076-2, aka
Super Mecha Demon Abel from the Bible.
The original Dr. Bright happened to be carrying 963-1 at the time when suddenly...
Bitch!
Ow! Why'd you kill me?
Mechademon Abel from the Bible then went on to kill a total number of more people before getting his ass manslaughtered again, but the bigger takeaway here was when a D-dude was cleaning up the mess and found 963-1 lying on the floor. He then picked it up before proceeding to neurotically brainstorm special containment procedure concepts like some kind of chaotic neutral creative genius. The SCP Foundation took note of this immediately, and not long after discovered that whoever touches 963-1 and or wears it around their neck, their brain stops functioning and they start behaving like Dr. Bright, reacting like Dr. Bright, and even calling themselves Dr. Bright. Jackie Boy just went and accidentally transformed into an indestructible amulet that can take over the minds of literally every living anthropoid upon physical contact with them and basically render himself immortal.
What is it? You demand an explanation as to why Dr. Bright reached the glorious achievement of immortality? Well, it is simple, you see. Firstly, cut off that stressful, bloody background music. We've already passed the climax and we still want the tone of this video segment to be nerve-wracking. For God's sake, this isn't a Christopher Nolan action thriller. It's just some silly SCP that some terminally online chap wrote in his mother's basement. For God's sake.
According to Dr. Bright, the creator of 963-1 made the amulet for the sole purpose of, get this, becoming immortal. Once they finished manufacturing it, with whatever paranormal method they used, all they had to do was hold the amulet and get someone other than themselves to kill them. They then proceeded to commit suicide. And Dr. Bright ended up acquiring immortality because, unlike the dumbass amulet builder who can't follow directions and will forever be dead and rotting, Dr. Bright actually got murdered by someone other than himself while holding the amulet and is now living forever.
And on accident, too. We truly live in a wacky collection of timelines, guys. I wonder how many things I could get away with as an immortal member of society.
Why are you so insufferable?
You are not immortal.
I know. Crazy. Just imagine the number of things only I am able to... Wait, can you repeat that for me, please?
You are not immortal.
I'm pretty sure I am.
Have you ever heard of the Swampman thought experiment?
The Scatman what now?
Let's say the two lightning bolts strike at the same time. One of them strikes a man named Jimmy, killing him instantly. The other ball strikes a nearby swamp that spontaneously rearranges the affected molecules in such a way that creates an identical copy of Jimmy at the precise moment of his death. This begs the question, is this the real Jimmy? Can we call this being the real Jimmy? In all multiverse where human spirits have been proven to be 99.9% canon, the answer is clearly no.
Yeah, I have no idea what you're talking about. It is time for me to switch with another body. My amulets possess this body for about 29 days, and if I wait another day, I'm gonna create a neurological clone of myself. And as much as I love how awesome I am, I do have the respect not to replace all of someone's thoughts and memories with that of my own. Am I right, boys?
Rest in peace, Dr. Bright.
Off to D-Class jail to infect another body.
Now look what you've gone and done. Well, that doesn't sound like fun. See, I'm not the only one. A copy of a copy of a...
Holy shit, I'm having an identity crisis.